You look fantastic.
Thank you. Hello. It is so good to see you. I see your hair has grown, even though you've cut it and it's grown again.
No matter what I do, it refuses to be quieted during this time.
I don't think your hair should ever be quieted. I think it should scream as loudly as it wants to, Conan.
Yeah, it was very, worried about the elections, and it's been, it is expressing a lot of inner turmoil right now.
Yeah, but I think somebody's got to.
Someone's got to. Let's talk about you and then talk much more about me.
Okay.
Congratulations, you were named Fashion Icon of 2020 at the People's Choice Awards on Sunday. Now, I congratulate you. That is also a lot of pressure because you are a fashion icon now.
Listen, it didn't feel like a lot of pressure to me. It felt like it finally validated my shopping habit. And I finally, I have to buy this. I'm a fashion icon.
Yes.
And now I sleep, these are my pajamas, Conan. This is now what I sleep in. No, not true. I actually stole this from my Bo Johnson's wardrobe at work.
Very nice. I take things from wardrobe whenever I can, mostly underwear, and then I put it back.
That's terrible. That's terrible.
I know. It's really bad.
I will return this tomorrow.
Well, you look amazing. You always look amazing. You always go the extra mile. Let me just ask you quickly. I don't even know how an award show works these days.
But woo!
People's Choice Awards, how do you walk a red carpet? And then usually the times when I've gone to an award show, it's a lot of hugging, handshaking, cheek kisses. What are they doing now?
None of that. There were only two photographers spread out, distance. They had partitions between them. You weren't anywhere in proximity to anybody else. I actually kind of overlapped with a friend of mine, Jamila Jamil, and we automatically, magnetically, started walking towards each other, but then we just moved into the bows. And it was yes, it's so nice to see you. And the air hugging. The only issue with the red, there's a ton of issues with all of this. First of all, it's very surreal to keep doing stuff like that in the middle of this, because it feels like, what are we doing? This is so weird. And then I would, you wear your mask until the last possible moment. Took my mask off, my makeup, my lipstick was like up my cheek and up
this way.
It's everywhere.
You probably look like Joaquin Phoenix's Joker, just sort
That's
of
exactly
smear.
Right.
Except,
up on the nose too. But, it feels fun to do safely some of those things.
To
create some semblance of, I really wanted to go because it was such a big deal. But then you're standing on that stage and all you hear is the echo of your voice because there's no one there.
Nobody there.
No one.
Nobody
you don't even know. Walk on the stage with somebody else. So it's, it's all good. These are really there's such real things going on in the world.
Right.
That a lovely, joyful, awkward award show is just fine. Cause there's,
I'm really glad that you mentioned the bow because, I started out doing the elbow bump, but for years in my monologue, I would give a little bow at the top of the show. And I'm finding that that's the way to go. I see people, and actually you brought up Jamila Jamil. I saw her recently because we both work on podcasts in the same building and there's hardly anybody there and everyone's wearing masks and it's all very safely done. But I saw her in the hallway and I did a big bow, which is one should bow to you and to Jamila Jamil. You are worthy of a bow. Although sometimes I'm bowing at a gas station attendant and it's
but
I don't know this guy. Is this guy
I feel like bowing is appropriate. I feel like you deserve a bow too. And I feel like a gas station attendant deserves a bow.
Not the one I'm talking about.
Okay, I understand
This guy was up to no good. I don't think he worked at the gas station. He was just wearing the uniform and trying to steal gas caps. So
does not deserve a bow. The elbow bump is honestly too close to me. I'm you're still way too close to me.
Right.
So this works and you can still make eye contact with the only sense that you get to see out of you. I touch my heart a lot. Oh, this is a hug.
Right. One thing I was doing for a while is the elbow bump, but I would lick it first. And that was just, I don't know why I was doing that. I was trying to add a little bit of eroticism to it. And I got a lot of complaints. So that
I think I'm glad you stopped that.
This is why I need friends like you. who are fashion icons, but also can tell me when I'm behaving inappropriately.